Hey there, YouTube. This is a quick video about blasphemy and blasphemy laws and why they are absolutely crazy. And my basic point is that ideas do not have rights. People have rights. We shouldn't be protecting ideas. We should be protecting people and their freedom of speech and freedom of ideas. This is God Vlogger. And here are my points about why, first of all, ideas do not have rights. What we're supposed to have is a marketplace of ideas, openly discussed, so that the best should rise to the top. Otherwise, how can we advance as a people, as a society, as a species, as a world, as a universe, if we can't have the best ideas come forth? All ideas should be open for public discussion and evaluation. And that's just basics. And bad ideas should not be protected. Why on earth would you want to protect a bad idea? And on the flip side of that, a good idea doesn't need to be protected. A good idea can stand on its own. A good idea has value. It has merit. It has points that would, make it a worthwhile idea to pursue or to believe or to implement. So no matter which way you look at it, good ideas don't need protection. Bad ideas shouldn't be getting protection. So why would we have something like blasphemy or blasphemy laws? Really, it's only by having an open, rational discussion and even debate that we can all form our own opinions. We can choose which ideas we want to promote and move forward for our societies. So on the flip side of my point that ideas do not have rights or should not have rights, people do have rights and people should have rights. And one of those rights is free speech. Free speech is absolutely necessary for a free society. And for free speech to exist, you really have to protect the unpopular speech. Speech that is unpopular, controversial, different, innovative. Perhaps even at times offensive, something that bucks the status quo. If it's just saying the same old thing that everybody already says and has said for many, many years, or that the government already says, that speech, doesn't really need, special protection because, there's no downside for saying something that everybody else and your government already say. But really the speech that does need protection is new, innovative, at times unpopular speech. And along the idea of people having rights, freedom of speech is a fantastic basic human right to express ourselves. On the flip side of that, there is no right to not be offended. Right? I can't say that, I hate the color gray, and therefore nobody should walk down the street wearing the color gray because you might offend me. And therefore, I should have the ability to dictate what you wear or don't wear. That would be called insanity, right? There's no right for me to not be offended. You could tell me that you think that my ideas are stupid. Okay, maybe that's not a polite way for you to put it, but you would have a right to tell me that. You could post that down in the comments. You could tell me that you like my voice, you don't like my voice, you like my color scheme of my YouTube videos. It doesn't matter. I don't have a right to not be offended. Nobody has a right to not be offended. There's basic societal interplay between people that takes care of all of that. If somebody says something offensive at a party, fine. Maybe nobody invites them to the next party. But you don't need a law to prevent people from being offended. On the flip side, free speech is such a cornerstone, again, I can't say this enough, that it needs to be present, it needs to be protected, it's a basic human right. So what can you do? Openly discuss topics as they come up, calmly, rationally, freely. Point out the insanity of blasphemy just as an idea. Blasphemy most commonly refers to religions. And why do religions get this free pass? Why is it that you could discuss all other topics openly and vigorously, but religions are considered so fragile that you were not allowed to publicly discuss or criticize them or doubt them in any way? It's just insane. You really have to ask yourself why. And really, to me, the answer is easy. that you know religions are on such a bare thread of connection to actual reality that everybody knows that they're so fragile that they actually would not stand up, you know, very well to public discussion and public debate. If you wanted to ask about, you know, why different religions believe different things, it's just because those religions are mostly crazy and delusional. But, you know, for some reason we're not allowed to, you know, discuss whether or not that is true. And maybe I'm right, maybe I'm wrong, but we'd never know unless we have an open discussion upon it based upon the evidence, based upon, you know, what rationality and open discussion would lead to. And really, you know, we have other areas in life where people feel passionately about something, and yet, you know, you might have a discussion about somebody about, you know, a difference of opinion on their favorite sports team, their favorite political candidate, their favorite political party, best economic policy for the country, parenting ideas, is it better to do parenting one way versus another way? And yet, you know, there's no laws, you know, or huge taboos against discussing those topics openly. And yet, when it comes to religion, somehow there's this, you know, there's this free pass that religion gets that we're not allowed to discuss it. Somehow we don't want to, you know, break that taboo. You know, there's this taboo that protects religion from open discussion. And I would suggest that we need to break that taboo and therefore break the spell that religion has our societies under. So those are my ideas on why blasphemy is crazy. And again, the main points is because ideas do not have rights. People have rights. This is God Vlogger. Please feel free to subscribe to these videos, rate them, make your comments and counter comments, you know, down below. And remember, blasphemy is crazy. People have rights, not ideas having rights.